San Antonio location at 17623 La Quintera Parkway, Suite 101 at the Rim. Different and delicious burgers, but fresh and all natural ingredients. Hop Dottie also has handcrafted milkshakes and hand-cut chinnabuck fries. So get to a Hop Dottie in San Antonio. When burger is life, life is awesome.
Jason Minix here for Alamo Water Softeners. Don't wait until you think you have a problem with your water before calling Alamo Water Softeners. Have Alamo Water Softeners come to your house and give you a free water analysis and free estimate. In the month of May, you can get a free reverse osmosis system with the purchase of select new water softeners while supplies last. Discover the Alamo Water Softeners difference. Go to alamowatersofteners.com. That's alamowatersofteners.com.
When it's more than just your lawn, it deserves the Kubota Z400. Get a head-turning offer on class-leading speed, agility, simple deck height adjustments, and a quality cut. When you need comfort and performance, then you need the professional-grade Kubota Z400. Right now, get the Kubota Z400 mower for zero down and 0% APR for 48 months or save $300 now through June 30th. See us or go to KubotaUSA.com for full disclaimer.
From the Gulf of Mexico to the hill country of Texas, Ewald Kubota is your Kubota dealer.
If you're a bacon lover, I've got great news for you. This is Michael Kielbasa with Kielbasa Smoked Meats. Our authentic dry-cured bacon is now available at grocery stores near you. We make it the old-fashioned way with the finest pork bellies and our legendary spice blend. We don't pump it full of water or chemicals like other brands. All you get is thick, savory slices of delicious bacon. I hope you'll give it a try. And if it's not the best bacon you've ever eaten, I'll give you your money back. Kielbasa Smoked Meats, slow-crafted in Texas since 1949.
This is for the men who never settle, the ones who believe only quitters end a game in a tie, the type of guys who choose the bar with the biggest TVs to overcompensate for theirs at home. This is the Lodge mentality. This is Twin Peaks.
Listen to this station anytime, anywhere on Odyssey. Odyssey is your new audio home for all the music, news, sports, and podcasts that matter to you. Odyssey. That's AUDACY.
Moonshine Patio Bar and Grill serves great cooking with an innovative take on classic American comfort food. For over 10 years now, Chuck and Larry have delighted appetites and presented one of the best Sunday brunches ever at 303 Red River in Austin. Go by and enjoy some corn dog shrimp, cornflake chicken salad, broiled rainbow trout, and all my favorites and more. Moonshine Classic American Comfort Food. And of course, when you see Chuck and Larry, tell them Foss said hello. Moonshine Patio Bar and Grill.
Laying Down the Law is brought to you by Texas Spine Care Center, Cover 3 San Antonio, Coordinated Financial Group, and Hop Dottie Burger Bar.
We're back. We are Laying Down the Law. Steve Foster alongside Mike Hardball Harge. And we are going to go now to the phone lines and talk to a young lady who I know very well. I call her, she's like the queen, Mike, the president and CEO of the Central and South Texas chapter of Make-A-Wish, the one and only Catherine Brewer. Catherine, good morning and welcome back to the show.
Good morning, Stephen. I especially like the young lady there.
Hey, listen, I'm telling you, I know this to be true. a big weekend coming up in Over the Edge, and it's a very unique opportunity as we want to let people know Make-A-Wish is one of the two primary charities of our show. And again, we welcome others as well, but Make-A-Wish is one of the two primary for the show because we certainly want to be supportive when it comes to charitable organizations and the good things they're doing. And so for the Central and South Texas chapter, which encompasses Austin and San Antonio and other counties surrounding, we do an event called Over the Edge Hardball, where you go down a building at least 30 plus stories, and it's all for charity. It's all for the children. And that event's coming up this upcoming Saturday, first weekend in June. Catherine, tell us about Over the Edge.
Oh, thanks so much for having us on, Stephen. You know, it's people think that Make-A-Wish is a last wish, and that can't be further from the truth. So many, now actually 92% of childhood diseases are treatable that were formerly fatal. But the key to survival is really your mental attitude. And it's Make-A-Wish invites children to take a leap and going from, you know, dealing with so much hardship, physical and mental pain, isolation, and to envision a brighter future and to envision something positive. And it really is a mental leap. And that's exactly what we do in Over the Edge. We have people who look down the side of a building, you know, tens of floors, 40, 50 floors, and they're saying, and take the mental leap and physical leap actually to go over and rappel down that building. And to trust, really, this group of people that are there to support them. It's the most awesome experience you can ever have to be hanging on the side of a building and looking all over the town and being able to see a view that nobody else sees because you've taken that chance.
I tell you, I'm not there yet. Ryan's done it. he went over the edge at the W Hotel. And kudos in that regard. Mike, would you do it?
I'm a little cool on that. I'm a cheer everybody on, and I'll let you know when you get to the bottom how impressed I am of your courage. But I kind of hang back on where I'm at on that. I just got in trouble because I said I didn't want to go zip lining on vacation. So I don't know if I want to fall down the sideline.
No, I don't want to make you guys feel bad, but we've actually had kids that are actually in wheelchairs go down.
Well, you did make me feel bad, so now I might have to do that.
But, you know, more importantly, I mean, this has been such a supportive experience for us. We are really struggling this year, you know, because of COVID. Half of our income is events, and our events have been just decimated by COVID because we can't get together. And so this is really a coming out party for us. And we're just so grateful for people that have raised funds to allow us to grant more wishes. We have a record number of wishes waiting right now, and kids who need it so desperately because their isolation and challenges are doubled by COVID. So we are just so, so grateful for everybody who's raised money this year to make this event such a success.
Catherine, go ahead, Mike.
I just wanted to ask about, you know, all the things that go into supporting Make-A-Wish. I know you said that you're having a tough time getting some of the information and finding the sponsorship, but when you're putting all this together, how many volunteers, how many people are involved that can make all of this come true? Because I'll tell you what, every time I see a Make-A-Wish story, tears are in my eye. I mean, it's so cool with some of the stuff that goes on. I'm just curious to how does all this come about?
I'm so glad, yes. And, you know, one thing I'd like to say even before I talk about the how is the why. And one of the most important things for us to realize is that by giving to others, we actually get the same experience ourselves of a shift in positive mental attitude, which actually affects our physical well-being. I'll tell you, this weekend, I contributed $300 to different pieces. One is Namaya, our wish kid who we lost this year, this week, actually, was suffering from bone cancer. Her family has struggled financially and physically to support her. And then another one was a pair of kids who were orphaned in New York from COVID. But what it gave me was the feeling of being being a part of somebody's survival. And that made me feel better this weekend, knowing that there's so many difficult things happening. So for Over the Edge, you know, a big part of this is our volunteers, and we have different groups that help us. Some of our big groups actually are, you know, we have the National Charity League, we have Jack and Jill, we have Chi Omega. There are some of our huge groups of volunteers, but we have a lot of individual volunteers that specifically our WISH families. Some of our WISH families are some of our biggest volunteers, and they spend all day at Over the Edge helping us greet repellers and escort them. And it's a really quite a empowering experience. We also, what's really neat is that the people who are helping us rappel are firefighters and people who really know how to work with ropes. And they come from all over the state and actually all over the country to help us set up our system so that it's very safe and secure. And these are people that, you know, rappel into caves and over cliffs and off buildings, and sometimes when they're on fire. And they really know how to set up the system so that we are safe and going over.
They can help you, Mike, with that zip lining effect too, buddy.
I know. I need some motivation.
Catherine, you had mentioned to me offline about us being able to possibly get back into Morgan's Wonderland in the San Antonio area where we've held World Wish Day before. And I got to hang out and kick around with all my favorite Star Wars characters and the like. Tell us about that and some other goings on that you had mentioned in San Antonio.
Sure. We have a great relationship with Morgan's Wonderland and their family. Every year on World Wish Day in the past, we have had a great celebration of wishes in the park. And we actually had a fundraising walk as well that was very well supported by SWBC and Valero and other of our favorite friends in San Antonio. That's been an incredible celebration where our families get together and get to just have a day where they're with people who have been through a similar experience. And then they're able to both, you know, give back to Make-A-Wish, but even more than that, they're able to just relax and celebrate their survival and the support that they've had from the community. We love Morgan's Wonderland. And so this year we've not been able to do anything, obviously, because we can't get together. But we're working on now a really exciting day of wishes at Morgan's Wonderland, where our wish kids from around the state and across the nation actually will come to Morgan's Wonderland to experience their wish. And I don't know how many people know what Morgan's Wonderland is, but basically it was built by Morgan's father because he wanted to create something where a place, it's like a theme park where kids who have disabilities can have the same experience that other kids had and to integrate with kids who don't have disabilities and just have a great time. It used to be, I mean, there's a lot of really wonderful pieces already. There's carousels and fishing and everything you can think of that's all wheelchair, handicapped accessible. But now they've created a water park as well. And so we're really excited about that. That means we can have this in the summer when it's hot and kids can have all kinds of fun. Again, a whole water theme park that's all handicapped accessible. So we're really excited to bring kids in from across the country to be a part of that.
We're talking with Catherine Brewer, the president and CEO of Make-A-Wish of Central and South Texas, the chapter that Austin and San Antonio reside in. And Catherine, how can people always need to let folks know if they're interested, how can they get more information? If I'm standing correct on my information, cstx.wish.org. Is that correct?
That's correct for our chapter. And then if you want to get specifically involved in Over the Edge, it's austinovertheedge.com. And you can donate to any repeller. We especially would like you to support our Wish Kids. But any repeller, you know, is much appreciated. I have an account that I'm going to give away. So you can do one under my name, too. And that'll go to one of our favorite Wish Kids It's Catherine Brewer. But yeah, please come and help us make this even more of a success. Help us grant more wishes.
I think Catherine, that's what I'm going to be on that side. I'm going to be on the donation side.
Well, you know, honestly, that makes the biggest difference for us. The repelling makes a difference for you.
See, that's why she's the president and CEO, Harge.
That's right.
She knows the correct and proper order of events. So, Catherine, also offline, I want to do this because it's Texas. I want to do the Texas two-step. So I want you or Jill or somebody next Sunday to come back, give us a wrap on the event and continue to talk as we move mid-year into Make-A-Wish and the different things that are going on. And, you know, and you've always been, again, awesome to come out and visit while we're doing our golf tournament that we put on for the show in New Braunfels, Atlanta Park Golf Course. That'll be Friday, July 16th. Get there at noon so you can eat before shotgun start. You'll see all of us out there. My man, Chad Donegan, big shout out to him and the rest of the staff at Atlanta Park as they do a great job. And it's located in between Schlitterbahn and Wurstfest. And so that's one of the things we look forward to. And raising money and donating. So, Catherine, I got to have somebody back next Sunday, so just plan on it. It certainly can be you, and we look forward to hearing all about Over the Edge and how that goes for Make-A-Wish of Central and South Texas.
Oh, thank you so much, Steve, and thanks for your incredible support. I don't know how many of you know, but Steve is on our board, and we are so grateful for all you've done, both with this sort of fundraising and your golf tournament and your work in the Capitol for us. So we look forward to talking about that, too. I got to tell you guys, Stephen is the most beloved guy in the Capitol. You can't walk 5 feet without finding him that wants to chat with him.
I do my best to be a statesman, absolutely. And working for the great state of Texas is also a privilege, and it's been fun. So, Catherine, we're going to have somebody back next week. I know that you can make it happen since you are the one and only president CEO of Make-A-Wish of Central and South Texas. We thank you for your time this morning and look to hear from the chapter next week. So thanks so much.
Thanks so much, Stephen. Thanks for having me. All right. Bye-bye. Happy Sunday.
Take care. All right. Happy Sunday to y'all as well. We'll be back. More to come right here on Laying Down the Law.
Texas Spine Care Center and Dr. Adam Brueggemann are committed to treating chronic back pain and helping patients understand and make informed decisions about orthopedic treatment. They focus on using the latest techniques, medicines, and practices to give their patients the best treatment options to manage and overcome pain. Texas Spine Care Center is committed to helping San Antonio find the best choices that will give you your life back. So call 210-941-1785 or go to TexasSpineCareCenter.com. 210-941-1785.
Time to fire up the grill.
Time to go to Total Wine. I want to find a new tequila or rum to make some fruity drinks. Maybe a margarita or a pina colada.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
Their guides can help us find the perfect flavor to pair with your famous grilled salmon. And you do love their beer cooler.
Ooh, a hoppy pilsner would make my famous salmon even better.
Wondrous selection, helpful guides, ridiculously low prices. Total Wine and more. Discover new flavors to make this summer even more fun at TotalWine.com.
I absolutely love my dog, but the constant shedding, not so much. But then I got a Swiffer Sweeper pet kit, and it is amazing. These super thick cloths pick up a crazy amount of hair. Just look at all that. And that was from just one swipe. And the best part? Sweeper's so much easier to maneuver than a broom or a vacuum, easily getting around chairs and under the couch. You're right. Now I can focus on you, not your shedding. Swiffer Sweeper Pet Kit. Because shed happens.
All right. Is that a Q2 or Q3 expense?
Dwayne's CPA went MIA. W-9. To keep his books and his sanity, he needs to find a replacement ASAP.
Hey, Johnny, have you ever heard of a fungible good?
Indeed can help him hire the people he needs.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. When you sponsor a job, you immediately get your short list of quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job criteria. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
Guys, you know that new Untuckit shirt you've been eyeing? Well, you can save 25% on everything in stores and online with Untuckit's annual Memorial Day event going on now. Untuckit shirts are made to be worn untucked so you can feel comfortable and look sharp all day. They're the only styles you need this summer. Untuckit's Memorial Day sale is the time to save on bestsellers like wrinkle-resistant linen and cool short-sleeve styles to help beat the heat. Just visit Untuckit.com or any of Untuckit's 80-plus stores to save 25%. Untuckit, shirts designed to be worn untucked.
Cover 3 at Stone Oak in San Antonio is the place to be. Whether you're looking to gather coworkers for lunch, dine with friends, or treat your sweetie to a fabulous dinner, this elegant restaurant offers ample seating with comfortable leather booths, tall cocktail tables, along with full-service dining at the bar, or you can enjoy a fun time out on the patio. So come to Cover 3 and experience dining, spirits, and sports.
Cover 3, 1806 North 1604 West, 210-479-9700.
In the early hours after the tsunami, it was ham radio that was on the air, saving lives. When Florida was ripped by hurricanes, the hams were there. In the critical moments after the attack of 9/11, it was the hams who coordinated emergency messages. When disasters strike, the hams are ready. Ham radio works when other communications don't. To learn how you can become a ham radio operator, call the ARRL, the National Association for Amateur Radio, at 1-800-326-3942.
Laying Down the Law is brought to you by Texas Spine Care Center, Cover 3 San Antonio, Coordinated Financial Group, and Hop Dottie Burger Bar.
We're back. We are laying down the law. Steve Bolter. Rod Chico Tanner, the good governor from the South Texas District of the AAU, and Mike Hardball Harge. And, you know, I got to let Chico do this as we bring on a familiar guest during Indy 500 weekend. Come on, Chico, give me that ladies and gentlemen start.
Ladies and gentlemen, start your engine.
And with that, we bring on the one and only Nick Firestone, live from Indianapolis, from the Brickyard. Nick, good morning. I know he's here.
We there?
Nick,
you got me?
I got you, buddy. Yes, you got us?
Yeah, I got you. So, how's it going?
Hey, man, we're excited. Listen, honest to goodness, I am coming with you next year. Come heck or high water, I will be in Indianapolis for this weekend with you. If you can get there, I am there with you, sir.
I was going to say, you got tickets?
Media, baby. Go with the media
credential. Now, Nick, well, you know, I mean, Steve, Steve better than that, Nick.
And I know. Yeah, that's why I said it. I'm just making sure nothing's changed. I'm in garage area right now. It's like supposed to be a little harder to get out on the track as usual because COVID and everything. But you know, there's a lot of fans here and stuff. Hold on.
Nick,
yes, sir. Go ahead.
I thought that they said today, and Hardball and I were talking about it, about 130 plus thousand fans today able to see the race.
Yeah. And, you know, it looks a little lighter than normal, but right now, you know, it's not much different than normal, which is nice to see. You know, I mean, I'm glad that they opened it up. I've had 10 seats here for years, and they originally told you I was going to get 8 of my 10, but the way they did the spacing, I got all 10 of 10. So, you know, I'm psyched. I got my full family and contingent here. And it's, you know, like I said, I mean, the people starting to file in the stands. I mean, right now, it, you know, it doesn't look much different. It probably look a little different on race day, but, you know, on race time, but I mean, it's great to see, you know, especially after this last year we've all been through, right? I mean, it's really good to see, you know, things get back to somewhat normal. So, you know, the drivers are, this is the fastest field in history. I don't know if you guys looked at that or not. Like, no, there's only like 2 mile an hour difference between the pole and the like last place guy or something ridiculous.
No, that's why we have you, Nick. You're the one that's qualified at Indianapolis. You're the one with the name on the tires and Harvey Firestone. That's why we call you, son.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it is the fastest field in history, and the amazing thing to me is I was watching qualifying, and, you know, they put the speeds up, and, like, when I was here, I was doing 230 miles an hour the turn in of turn one and three, you know, at the end of the big straightaways, but my speed fell to, like, 217 mid-corner, and now they only lose, like, 6 miles an hour in the turns. I mean, it's nothing, you know? So when you see the average of like 232, they're pretty much going that speed the whole way around. It's really impressive to me that they can actually go through the corners that much faster. I mean, obviously, you know, tire technology, car technology, everything, but it's just insane to me. There's like literally like no change in speed, you know?
I got a quick question, and I know we're getting close to our break here, but with that in mind, how does that, from a G-force perspective, because a lot of people don't realize the G-force that people are encountering there is pretty heavy. And if they're doing that, has that anything changed there for the drivers?
Well, you're more supported ever in these cars because your head is literally like popped into a headrest, so it's supported and it literally can't move, you know, which is kind of weird. It takes a little getting used to. And then, you know, the seats, they literally pour the seats for these guys. And it's, you know, you're custom fit into the car. But to your point, when you add 10 miles an hour at the center of the corner, that's a lot of force. I mean, I the G-forces have to be as high as they've probably ever been. And luckily for everyone, it's a little bit cooler day because obviously after 200 laps, that's going to take a toll physically. And so, you know, they got a nice day for the race and should be awesome, you know, in terms of the weather. And hopefully the weather, like, hopefully the thicker air, like, lets them run closer together and everything else. But, yeah, they're definitely going to be pulling some G's today for sure.
So I do want to ask one question before we let them go. What is it like to drive that fast in a car? I mean, I know it's racing. I know it's part of the job and everything. But you were talking about going 300 miles an hour and then slowing down 15 miles an hour. That's still amazing speed. Like, what is that like?
Well, I tell everyone, I mean, even for racing drivers, the speeds here are like nothing you've ever seen anywhere else in your career, you know? And when you start going that fast, me personally, it takes my brain a day to get used to it. But B, like, everything gets really narrow. Like, your sight line gets really narrow. So the turns look like much narrower and the banking seems to disappear. And I mean, it's just amazing. I mean, it's, you know, I say it's like, it's a whole different zip code here in terms of speed. And it's like nothing else you've experienced anywhere else. And it takes a little getting used to, in my opinion. Especially this place, because, you know, it is so tricky with the long straightaways and, you know, you're flying through these corners and you have like a split second, like after turn one to, like, you know, get the car ready in the short shoot, and then that disappears and now you're in turn two, and then you got this big long straightaway to think about what's coming. You know, every time you do a lap, you got a long straightaway to think about what's coming. And that's probably the saving grace concentration wise, because it's just, you know, you can't make a mistake here. You literally can't put a foot wrong. There's consequences, you know, like nowhere else. So it's pretty amazing experience. Let's put it this way. I was so nervous here. I was more nervous here on a practice day than I would be on like race day anywhere else. And I had to make myself eat every morning because you know, you're going so fast and it's like, just gets your attention. It's hard to, like, you know, hard to relax.
Wow. So, Nick, before we let you go, who do you think wins today at this Indianapolis 500?
Well, that's the beauty of it, right? Like, I don't know. You know, I think I pick him every year, you know, but I really like Tony Kanaan. He's, like, qualified really well. He's a master at, like, restarts. He's a master at the start, you know, like, passing people on cold tires. So if the race comes down to, you know, a late race yellow and, you know, they got to do a restart. And, you know, Tony Khan's anywhere in the top three. Like, I think he's really hard to beat. So that's my guy for today.
All right, man. Well, you're our guy always. We certainly appreciate it. I'm going to be in the contingent next year, Nick Firestone. So go ahead and book it.
I've heard. I got the memo. So, yeah, I heard.
Hey, and what people don't know is that we make a heck of a spades team, too. We can play spades all night. We definitely aim to please. And I appreciate you, man.
Yeah. Exactly. So, yeah, I'll have to, like, brush up on my spades if you're coming next year. You know, I don't need to lose any more money if my bets don't work out. So.
No doubt.
All right, guys. Hey, I'm in.
No problem. We appreciate you. We got to go.
It's part of the weekend for me.
Exactly. We got to go, man. Nick, thanks as always. Up next. The AAU Focus on Youth Sports and our man Rod Chico Tanner. Stay with us. More to come right here on Laying Down the Law.
San Antonio has two Hop Dottie locations. Hi, I'm Steve Foster. One at the Rim and the new location at the Vineyard. 1301 North Loop 1604 West. And the initial San Antonio location at 17623 La Quintera Parkway, Suite 101 at the Rim. Different and delicious burgers, but fresh and all natural ingredients. Hop Dottie also has handcrafted milkshakes and hand-cut Kennebuck fries. So get to a Hop Dottie in San Antonio. When burger is life, life is awesome.
Do you hear My Computer Career ads and think, I don't know anything about computers? Well, you don't have to. Before starting, many graduates could turn a computer on and off. And that's it. Now they're IT pros. You could do it too. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and take the free career evaluation. You could start your new life in as little as 4 months. Grants covering up to 53% of the cost are available to those who qualify. It's not rocket science. It's My Computer Career.
Does learning a language feel like this?
No habla español.
Hablo.
It's hablo?
Yes.
It's hablo.
When you learn a language, you want to actually use it. Babbel is designed with that goal in mind.
Since my husband is from Guatemala, I'll apply what I've learned in Babbel to our real life situations.
The app is so easy to use and it's so practical. It helps you learn things that you will actually need.
Babbel, language for life, celebrating 10 million subscriptions sold. Now try Babbel for free at Babbel.com. That's Babbel.com, Babbel.com.
When the doctor told us about my mom's cancer, it made me feel so helpless. Until I called the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society and spoke with Grace, who answered all of my questions about the disease, treatment options, and cancer-related expenses. Her support and compassion made us feel whole again. Today, I'm calling Grace to let her know my mom is beating cancer. To learn more, visit lls.org.
Summer savings are on at Lowe's with $10 off 1 gallon cans of paint and $40 off 5 gallon pails via Lowe's gift card rebate and savings up to $500 off select major appliance purchases. Shop Lowe's this Memorial Day. Lowe's, home to any budget, home to any possibility. Actual sizes 110 to 640 fluid ounces. Paint offer valid through 6221. See Lowe's.com/rebates for more details and restrictions. Must ask store to apply discount or enter promo code online. Can't be combined with more discounts. Savings vary based on eligible total purchase. See Lowe's.com for restrictions. Valid through 6921. U.S. only.
Moonshine Patio Bar and Grill serves great cooking with an innovative take on classic American comfort food. For over 10 years now, Chuck and Larry have delighted appetites and presented one of the best Sunday brunches ever at 303 Red River in Austin. Go by and enjoy some corn dog shrimp, cornflake chicken salad, broiled rainbow trout, and all my favorites and more. Moonshine classic American comfort food. And of course, when you see Chuck and Larry, tell them Foss said hello. Moonshine Patio Bar and Grill.
Laying Down the Law is brought to you by Texas Spine Care Center, Cover 3 San Antonio, Coordinated Financial Group, and Hop Dottie Burger Bar.
Back, and it is time now for the AAU Focus on Youth Sports and we shift to our man. You see how I did that for the Indianapolis 500. We shift to Rod Chico Tanner, the governor of the South Texas District of the AAU. Chico.
Hey, good morning. Good morning. We're rocking, man. There's a lot going on. I'm going to move quick into some quick little intros. But next Saturday, June 5th, we're at Eastview High School, Georgetown ISD for the primary championships and also the Extreme Force Invitational. Probably expecting about, 600 plus athletes there. So it'll be fun. Also want to send a big shout out to Jordan Clarkson, the Sixth Man Award in the NBA. He was a huge participant in the South Texas District of the AAU, went to multiple track and field Junior Olympics, played some AAU basketball right out of San Antonio and Wagner High School. So big shout out to the Sixth Man in the NBA coming right out of the South Texas District of the AAU, baby. Recognize that.
Say it with your chest, baby.
And, you know, so got, hey, big proud moment, you know, good friends with him and his dad. So excited. So want to bring on our volleyball director for our district, doing some great things. Want to talk about what's going on with volleyball in the district. We've got Coach Rodriguez. He is out of Floresville, Texas, runs TNT volleyball out there, but is also hosting some great events. And we'll talk about one of them. Hey, Coach Rodriguez, how you doing today?
Doing great. Looking forward to talking to your show today. Thank you for having me as a guest.
Good morning, awesome. Coach.
So, Coach, tell us about the national championship that is going to be hosted in Floresville. Give us the background on that.
Yes, during the pandemic last year, you know, the facilities were closed. We had nowhere to have a drill scout out there and play. Long story short, we thought about outdoor events. Beach volleyball was a great avenue. We got swamped and sold out all our events in beach volleyball during that pandemic, since you can only play, you know, outdoor sports. And we were limited on facilities. So, you know what? What about grass volleyball? Pitched the idea to the national office. They mulled it over a couple of weeks. And that led to the first inaugural AU Junior Girls Volleyball Championships to be held right here in Floresville, Texas, July 23rd to 25th for junior girls ages 12, 14, 15, 16, 18U. So this event being marketed across the country, even to U.S. territories such as Puerto Rico. And I mentioned Puerto Rico because we already have teams coming from Puerto Rico as well. California, New Mexico, Arizona, and Oklahoma. They'll be sending teams out here as well. So they're on their way, as well as our Texas teams.
Awesome. So that is grass volleyball. It's the inaugural. It was a great idea you had, Coach. And tell us the format for grass volleyball versus beach volleyball.
Format is 4-on-4. It's a regular size court. So like the indoor court as opposed to beach court, which is a little bit smaller. 4-on-4, combination of rules between your indoor and grass rules. So we'll have that on our webpage shortly because a lot of people are asking questions about that. And we're pretty much following national events as well. So what they use for the ruling and mimic what they're doing. And, you know, it's going to be out there summertime. We have morning waves, mid-afternoon waves, and even a nighttime wave to play underneath the lights. So that's something special as well.
Awesome. I am so excited. You know, I am already slated to be there. I'm there to support you. And, you know, tell people how they can register their 4-on-4 junior girls teams for the inaugural AAU Grass National Volleyball Championships.
Yes, they can go right up to our webpage, tntsasports.com, click on tournaments, and you have all the listings there for grass tournaments, which are preparatory tournaments. We have some preparatory tournaments coming up to prepare your teams for the upcoming AU National Championships for grass. And then, of course, you have the registration link for the Junior Girls Volleyball Championship, Grass Volleyball Championships as well, to register your teams. And this is something we just mailed out, close to 8,000 postcards. So if there's any club players listening out there, they're probably going to receive the postcard or already received it this weekend or will receive it the next couple of days. So please sign up your team to go out there, support Texas, as we got teams from all over the country attending this event.
Coach, I wanted to ask you, I know that the new grass is the inaugural one, but my question is, when did beach volleyball become so prominent with the young players? I know that a lot of colleges are playing it now, and it was something that I thought was more of just for the fun and you wanted to play beach volleyball, but then now the youth are playing a lot of that. How did that come about?
Well, that primarily came around, I mean, talking some of the history that I know about, came out from the D1 programs requiring their players to do beach volleyballs in off-season training, simply because there's less impact on the joints, but still practice the skills, and then you have different elements to work against, you know, the wind, the weather, stuff like that. And took a couple of years, but now they actually have Division I programs for beach volleyball, Division II, some NIA schools that are actually giving scholarships for that. And that's something that the juniors got into and looked at it, and now you have beach events all over the country. So our beach teams travel to Florida, they travel to California, they travel to right next to Louisiana and Alabama to attend, you know, beach tournaments out there, because it's just 2-on-2 and it's a phenomenal event. So it's grown as fast as growing sports in the NCAA, and more universities offering beach scholarships for those programs.
Coach, also, I think the U.S. has seen beach volleyball in the Olympics as well, and seeing those players play. So there needs to be a pipeline for our Olympic athletes, and this would be a great way to have them come up through the ranks.
That is correct, and that's what we're offering as well. In addition to the grass tournament, which is a new program for us, we've been running beach programs for the AAU organization the last 3 years, and we've been filling out just about every tournament. Even when it rained, we played this past weekend in the rain, and actually 2 weekends ago, not Memorial Day, but 2 weekends ago, and the kids were out there, you know, plain and torrential rain, but we got it done. So great excitement for the girls. They loved it.
So everyone listening, and of course, we'll put this information out. You know, you can visit TNT Sports, and it was TNT. Give us the website again, Coach.
It's www.TNT, like Dynamite SA for San Antonio, sportsplural.com. So TNTSASports.com. You can also reach me at 830-477-9640 or email me at tntsasports@gmail.com. We answer the phone all the time. So we have been getting bombarded, as you can, you know, determine, with all this publicity with the grass tournament, beach tournament. So, yes, we'll be there to return your call or answer your call or return your emails.
Awesome. And anyone else looking for opportunities to participate in some of the 38 different sports hosted and run by the AAU, you can go to aausports.org. That is the national website, and you can search around for a lot of different things. Lots going on in the South Texas district, a lot going on in the region, and a lot going on nationally with AAU sports across the board. Coach Rodriguez, thank you so much for being part of our AAU Focus on Youth Sports, and we look forward to seeing you real soon.
Looking forward to it. You have yourself a great day. Thank you.
I like that, Chico. You know, we see Misty May and all these other Olympians from the U.S. winning and playing against the Brazilians and the Canadians and everything in beach volleyball. It's great now to give the girls another opportunity on grass. Well played. Yep. Well played. Well, listen, y'all, we're going to have one in the books. We're going to come back at the top of the hour and get into some baseball, get into some NBA playoffs, a whole bunch more. Chico can tell us about getting geared up for the Junior Olympics to be held in Texas. So stay with us. Hour number two coming up on Laying Down the Law right after this. For Hardball, Chico and myself will be back.
Texas Spine Care Center and Dr. Adam Brueggemann are committed to treating chronic back pain and helping patients understand and make informed decisions about orthopedic treatment. They focus on using the latest techniques, medicines, and practices to give their patients the best treatment options to manage and overcome pain. Texas Spine Care Center is committed to helping San Antonio find the best choices that will give you your life back. So call 210-941-1785 or go to texasspinecarecenter.com. 210-941-1785.
It's the perfect season for a powerful business upgrade with Dell Technologies Summer Sale Event. Save up to 45% on secure PCs built for business with Windows 10 Pro. You'll also find great savings on Dell servers, monitors, docks, and other accessories to help boost productivity. Plus, enjoy free shipping on everything. Do more with modern devices and Windows 10 Pro. Call 877-ASK-DELL for a Dell Technologies advisor who can help you find the right tech. That's 877-ASK-DELL for business specials during Dell's Summer Sale Event.
Now's the time to get a great deal on Kubota construction equipment. Featuring durable Kubota engines, more comfort, more productivity, more get it done right. The Kubota construction lineup shows up ready to work every day. Right now, bring home select Kubota equipment for zero down, 0% APR for up to 60 months, or save up to $11,000. Now through June 30th, 2021. See us or go to KubotaUSA.com for more details.
From the Gulf of Mexico to the hill country of Texas, Ewald Kubota is your Kubota dealer.
Cover 3 at Stone Oak in San Antonio is the place to be. Whether you're looking to gather coworkers for lunch, dine with friends, or treat your sweetie to a fabulous dinner, this elegant restaurant offers ample seating with comfortable leather booths, tall cocktail tables, along with full-service dining at the bar, or you can enjoy a fun time out on the patio. So come to Cover 3 and experience dining, spirits, and sports.
Cover 3, 1806 North 1604 West, 210-479-9700.
The day my son died, it was beautiful outside. He went for a ride on his motorcycle and was hit by a car 1 mile from home.
On average, a motorcyclist is killed on Texas roads every day.
There is nothing that can prepare you for when they come to you and tell you that your husband has been killed.
Today, I saw a tarp-covered body laying in the middle of an intersection. It was a motorcyclist.
Look twice for motorcycles. There's a life riding on it. Brought to you by TxDOT.
How can you help fight cancer? You can team up with friends, rally your neighbors, and inspire your community to join Relay for Life of San Antonio. It's the American Cancer Society's biggest fundraising event, and it helps fund breakthrough cancer research, free rides to chemo, and free places to stay in your hospitals. Together, we can beat our biggest rival. So join us today at RelayForLife.org and help attack cancer in our community. RelayForLife.org. Again, that's RelayForLife.org for more information.
From the Mother's Window Tint Studios,
online at mothersWindowTint.com.
1250 ESPN San Antonio and 94.5 FM KCDC San Antonio.
We are Laying Down the Law. I, alongside Rod Chico Tanner and Mike Hardball Harge. Chico, man, it is great to have you right. You're usually so busy. I just want people to know that you are definitely a mainstay, one of our co-hosts for life. You've been a big part of youth sports, man, and even when you didn't have anyone participating, you've served thousands of youth. You're on national committees for AAU. You represent us extremely well. You don't ask for accolades. You just ask for an opportunity. And I want people to know that you, as time goes on, may have things that you're doing now as the governor of the South Texas District that has thousands of student athletes. So I wanted to get the message across that it's not that you don't take the show seriously or anything, but you are seriously volunteering and coordinating amongst a great region of the state of Texas. You know, we've had Kellen Mond, who I think the A&M contingent knows about. He stood out in the Senior Bowl, most passing yards in A&M history. He's also been a big contributor in the AAU program. So a lot going on with you, Chico, and I just wanted to set the stage so people recognize that, you know, well, where's Chico and how come he may come on intermittently? Well, that's because he's serving others and putting others before himself, and we see
the triple OG that thing going on.
Exactly. So he's handling his while we handle ours. Bro.
And I gotta say, Steve, I appreciate all of that. You know me, man. Great. Thank you so much. You know, in conjunction with that, you know, I still have a full-time job working in the IT industry. You know, I have a household. I've been married 30 years. You know, I've got a daughter trying to finish up college. You know, so it there's family.
And you get that weekend smoker grill going, and we need some more. See, that's what the pandemic took away.
Yeah, funny you say that. As soon as the show is over, it will be lit. So, I've already got the. I seasoned some of the meat last night, so it's ready to go, brother. Unfortunately, I can't share it. You know, if we were back in studio, you know, I love to bring it in studio, but I appreciate that. And, you know, and again, I say, you know, like Hardball yourself, and, you know, you talk about Make-A-Wish and everything you're doing there. It takes people like this community that we're involved in to make these things happen. The parents, the volunteers, you know, people who step up, you know, and do stuff, and it's not their children, it's not their youth, but they're willing to sacrifice and help try to make this a better society. I think sports does a lot for us, and it opens up doors. It enlightens people. It brings awareness. You know, we can go into long political conversations about it. We can go into conversations about the climate of our society and our nation and the world. And sports is one of those things that can bring us all together. And I love sports, man. I was watching, you know, Chelsea win the European Championship yesterday. I'm watching golf. I'm, you know, basketball. Yesterday, I'm gonna tell you, I spent the better part of several hours watching Converse Judson girls softball team play Austin Bowie for the regional championship. It was live streamed, and big shout out to my Judson Rockets punching their first ticket to the state tournament. So Austin Bowie girls softball team, amazing pitching. They did great, but they went up against the comeback kids, the Judson Rockets. Man, they were down in both games and came back to win it, and they're on their way to their first state tournament. The Lady Rockets, first regional championship in the history of Judson High School. So, but again, that's what I do, man. I love supporting youth sports and getting and providing opportunities for people. So it's exciting.
Absolutely. And what people don't realize is that Mike and myself, you know, we came from these systems as well. I think you said you played tennis in high school and some other things.
My 7th, 8th grade year, my freshman year, I played tennis, and then I moved over to soccer, you know, that junior, senior year. So, yeah, man, and ran track. I ran AAU track from the time I was 8 to 18, and I played all sports, man, growing up. And I saw a lot of that volunteerism and philanthropy being done, so I grew up around it. You know, it was like I just thought that was the norm, that everybody stepped up and did it. I didn't realize as I got older that it wasn't the norm, but I just assumed that, well, everybody volunteers and everybody helps. That's what we do. Well, I'm learning.
The other thing is, Chico, and I've learned this from outside of sports, the most important and critical time in youth lives where they unfortunately go the wrong direction is about from 3 to 7 p.m. And when you have sports and other activities, you're not out there being preyed upon on those that want to bring you into the wrong way in life.
Or make a bad decision.
And that 3 to 7 p.m. is when a lot of practice time goes on for these various sports for boys and girls who are student athletes. And so to put them into a structure and have them participate and have people who are volunteering and coaching to look out after these generations as they come through the ranks is very important. So having a group like y'all that provides 30 some different options for, you know, not just the football, basketball, baseball, not just the softball, volleyball, track for girls, but other sports, you know, swimming and diving, volleyball, grass, badminton, you name it. There's so many things that can be helpful to the society as well as the student athletes.
So, you know, the other thing that I'll say about the youth in our communities, and this is for everybody that's listening to the show and wants to do stuff, you know, the most formative times, elementary and middle school, if you don't catch them around elementary and middle school and get them some guidance, you know, it's almost, by the time they get to high school, it's almost too late. You know, in hardball, you're involved in stuff, man. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, it's a very, very trying time for these young athletes, these young minds. But you brought it up a little while ago, Chico. You talked about community, having everybody involved. And if you live in a community that is actively around a bunch of kids and trying to give them outlets so they could have other things to do. You know, I was fortunate enough, my kids are into athletics, so they have another group of friends that they're learning from. Well, you know, and then you got your school friends, and if you can bring them all together and have them all participating in different things, it'll help, number one, culturally, because everybody ain't the same. You know what I'm saying? Everybody's got an opportunity to learn something about somebody else and the challenges in which some that you think you're fortunate enough to have, that you say, oh, wait, he can't go and do this because he's not able to do this. Well, how can we help him and help them understand another way of life? So I love the AAU programs. I love the fact I grew up, and we've talked about this before. I mean, every day I was at the Boys and Girls Club. And Steve, you talked about the fact of where we were growing up in that time from 3 to 7. When right. You get a chance to be vulnerable to others, you get to go to a Boys and Girls Club or get on your AAU team. Now you're being funneled in the right direction and being educated where you can help someone else as well.
I'll say this. I spent a lot of time at the Eastside Boys and Girls Club in San Antonio. And the Eastside Boys and Girls Club had a registration into AAU as well.
Yeah.
So it was a collaborative, you know, move, because the Boys and Girls Club had the kids, AAU had the format, and it was a perfect marriage when I was growing up. Yep. You know, so you're spot on, man, in what you're saying, you know, and the things that are exciting to me is all the things that are coming about that we are doing. And like Steve, like you said, you know, we're really trying to grow like our golf program. We're really trying to, our taekwondo program is huge in our district. You know, swimming, we had a huge swimming program and it's kind of gone down. And of course, COVID affected that. So we're trying to rebuild our swimming program. So there's so much out there that creates that environment and the community side of it. Hardball, you, man, you're spot on. And I'm glad you recognized, you know, the statements I was making, because that's the difference in our society. We talk about all the things that are going on and, you know, the situations that have happened over the last several years that have brought in a lot of attention to reform of our judicial system, to reform of our police system, you know. But, you know, we can build that foundation. We eliminate a lot of that before it even gets to that point.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, I think, you know, along with this, the secret sauce, besides doing what you need to do during this time during school, is if you really want to get a good position to play in high school, if you really want an opportunity to do some things on the next level, college and university, and even have the opportunity, as some of the mentions, for a profession, play multiple sports. That's really the secret sauce. And all of us have done that, and we've taught that to the folks coming up alongside and behind us, because you really learn from different coaches, different teammates, different environments. And just so you know, 90%+ of all NFL players played multiple sports. And I'm sure that's the same for baseball, basketball, golfers. And they were talking about it and the PGA Championship of those golfers were a heck of baseball players. One guy played football, you know, so they did a lot.
Gary Woodland was a basketball player and was going to Kansas to hoop.
Who's that?
Woodland.
Oh, Gary Woodland?
Yeah, he's a hooper. A bad one, too. Yeah.
Wow. So, like I said, you want to have choices and you want to have the ability to be multifaceted. And the community and the support all lend to that. And we do periodically take the time to express that on the show.
Yeah.
We just don't want to report. We want to give you some insight because Hardball's got his Topps baseball card and played professionally against guys that have been, you know, all through the NLCS, ALCS, World Series, different things like that. You know, Chico's been around gold medalists and been around, you know, SEC champions and different folks like that, and national champions, and the young lady.
Well, Steve, you know, we talked about it.
High school.
I mean, yeah, we talked about it, and that's what I was going to say. You talked about Kellen Mond, and I just mentioned Kellen Mond, who played at A&M, played football, and Jordan Clarkson, who plays for the Utah Jazz. Both of those came out of the South Texas District of the AAU. Both of those guys ran AAU track. Both of those guys ran track in high school. They played basketball. You know, they played multiple sports growing up. Now, you know, Kellen Mond's on his way to the Minnesota Vikings, and Jordan Clarkson's playing for the Jazz, but they were multi-sport athletes. And it's the proof's in the pudding. You know, even Jeff Blake was a multi-sport. You know, Reggie Swinton, who runs the Arkansas AAU football program, played for the Cowboys and the Lions. Reggie was a standout track athlete, and he played basketball as well. And then he went on to play in the NFL. I mean, the proof's in the pudding.
We're trying to give the secret sauce, and we can't tell parents what to do. But however, we just want to give you what we know to be true, and that has worked. And who's the young lady that went to Wagner that just won the NCAA basketball tournament? She was so excited to win in front of her hometown. Who went to Wagner? The basketball shooting guard.
Yeah, that was William. And I don't know why I can't remember her first name. William. Right. Yeah. And it's funny because she ran track as well. There you go. Now she's on her way to the WNBA.
As a national champion, won in her hometown. And she probably never would have thought that Final Four was going to be in her hometown for her to get an opportunity to win in her senior year. So all these things can happen. We're going to step aside and come back and talk some baseball and keep going. So stay with us right here on Laying Down the Law.
Hi, I'm Todd Simon, the fifth-generation family owner of Omaha Steaks. There's nothing I love more than putting a steak on the grill for Father's Day. With Dad's Day right around the corner, send him more than just a gift. Send him an experience with the Get Out and Grill assortment. This package includes 20 entrees he's guaranteed to love. My personal favorite is the 10-ounce butcher cut New York strip. Plus, you'll get 4 New York strip burgers free with your order. Visit omahasteaks.com and type rare in the search bar. That's omahasteaks.com, keyword rare.
Panera favorites are hot and ready to serve for dinner. Taste our creamy mac and cheese served in a crispy bread bowl. Or the classic bacon turkey Bravo featuring our signature sauce. How about our new mouth-watering Chipotle chicken and bacon flatbread pizza? These and other favorites are waiting for you. Order dinner tonight for delivery or pickup. Only at Panera. Availability and pricing may vary.
San Antonio has 2 Hop Dottie locations. Hi, I'm Steve Foster. One at the Rim and the new location at the Vineyard, 1301 North Loop 1604 West. And the initial San Antonio location at 17623 La Quintera Parkway, Suite 101 at the Rim. Different and delicious burgers, but fresh and all natural ingredients. Hop Dottie also has handcrafted milkshakes and hand-cut Kennebunk fries. So get to a Hop Dottie in San Antonio. When burger is life, life is awesome.
Hi, I'm Heisman Trophy winner Danny Werfel. In 2011, I was sidelined by a rare condition called Guillain-Barré syndrome that left me weak and unable to move for months. We know Zika can have devastating effects on pregnancy, including severe birth defects. But did you know Zika can also cause Guillain-Barré syndrome? The good news is there are simple steps you can take to protect yourself, your community, and the next generation from Zika. Learn more at cdc.gov/preventzika.
I wasn't prepared to be a caregiver to mom. I had no idea how hard it would be and what I would need to know. Things I never thought of, like how to improve her mood and ways for me to stay positive. Luckily, I found the Caregiving Resource Center from AARP. It had articles about the basics, but also information about the hurdles I was facing. Caregiving Resource Center at aarp.org/caregiving. Articles, tips, and tools to help you both care for your loved one and care for yourself. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Hey, Dr. Phil here. You know, I help people solve difficult problems every day, but one problem has me stumped: childhood hunger. Nearly 16 million children in America struggle with it. Luckily, the Feeding America network of local food banks collects surplus food, giving hope to hungry children and their families. But they need your help. Join me in supporting Feeding America and your local food bank at feedingamerica.org.
Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Welcome back to The Cat Show. Up next, we have Nico. Nico is a member of the Shelter Pet Group.
That's right. A group known especially for their sunspot sleeping, ball chasing, leg rubbing, and of course, companionship. Just look how she struts.
It's like she owns the place.
And see how she curls up and cuddles her person.
The pitch on her purring is simply perfect.
Nice one.
Fantastic cat. But really the best way to know an amazing shelter pet like Nico is to meet one.
Visit theshelterpetproject.org today. Adopt.
Brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
Laying Down the Law is brought to you by Texas Spine Care Center, Cover 3 San Antonio, Coordinated Financial Group, and Hop Dottie Burger Bar.
We're back. We're laying down the law. Rod Chico Tanner. Mike Hardball Hard. Hardball. It is baseball season, son. Lot going on.
Yes, it is.
I got a chance to watch the Arkansas Razorbacks play against Ole Miss in the SEC tournament semis yesterday. But
my boy Jalen Battles.
Oh, tell me about him, the shortstop from Arkansas. Give me that, Chico.
So watch this. His uncle and I are best friends, grew up together, went to elementary school, graduated from Judson together. His dad and I went to elementary school together. Great kid. Played some stuff in AAU in the South Texas district. Another one coming from the South Texas
district. Like DJ Khaled.
Another one. Yeah. So, Jalen, man.
Where Battles from, Chico?
He's from San Antonio, Texas, baby. That's right. Madison High School, baby. Recognized.
Man, I didn't know. I was watching him yesterday, man. Shortstop doing the thing. I was like, look at this dude.
Yeah, dude.
Nice.
Hey, watch this. 6'3" shortstop.
I know.
Slick with it too.
Boy can hit the ball. He actually got out of high school. He got drafted, but didn't go. That team up in the Washington D.C. area wanted him, but it wasn't the right time yet. He went
I
to.
I had no idea. I was watching him. They were, they won 3-2 against Ole Miss, and he was addicted to. He got caught stealing. He got caught stealing. But, it was close. They went to the review. He just was behind the tag. They got him, but
the boy is 6'3". Yeah, he can. He's got speed. He's got the field vision. He can hit the ball. He can take it deep too, man. He's taken it out of the park several times this year.
That's so good to hear. I mean, like I said, they're the number one ranked team. They're in the championship of the SEC tournament now after beating Ole Miss, and great to know he has the Madison Maverick link in San Antonio.
Known him since he was a baby. Yeah, wow. Man. Yeah. So I will say, definitely that Arkansas program, man, they are balling out. The staff has done an amazing job in bringing those kids together, because he came from a JUCO. He was at a JUCO for a couple of years, I believe it was a year or two. Then went on to Arkansas. So. Great job from the Arkansas Razorbacks coaching staff.
Hardball.
Yeah, that's what it's all about. You know, I'm seeing a lot of us out there playing in the college games, and we're getting a chance to highlight some of those players from this area that probably wouldn't get a lot of love. And you said it, Arkansas has been the number one team in the nation for the majority of the year. And the more that you're the number one team, the more opportunities you're going to get to be seen. You're going to play on a higher level, and you're going to get these opportunities. So I'm excited. You know, unfortunately for the Texas Longhorns, they bowed out yesterday to Oklahoma State in a tough, tough matchup. But we're getting ready to find out about the regionals here pretty soon. It looks like Texas is going to be a national number one, not number one, but top five, top eight seed. So they'll get to host a regional starting next week. And this is where it starts to really, you get to find out how these teams really play it out. Like I said, Arkansas has been the number one team all year. Now every margin of error gets smaller and smaller and smaller. Tennessee's a tough, tough team. I got a chance to call Tennessee games last year, and I saw them early in the season. Just like this year, I got a chance to call TCU. I got to call Oklahoma. I got to call a bunch of the Big 12 games and see different teams across the country. Dallas Baptist is another team that brings it every week. In the Pac-12, Arizona is a team that you got to be on the lookout for. I saw those guys early, and the way that they hit the baseball makes you say, okay, they got an opportunity to be in the mix. So we got a lot of stuff that's been going on when it comes to baseball right now.
So, and real quick, in women's softball, UT women tied up the Super Regional with Oklahoma State yesterday. So they go to game three today. Yep. So winner of that will punch their ticket to the softball World Series. So UT women had not beaten Oklahoma State all year.
I know.
They had to win that game, and they came back to win it. So that'll be a great game today for that last – one of the last spots in the women's softball World Series.
What's the Big 12 look like now, Harge?
Today, Oklahoma State and TCU will play for the Big 12 championship. But as far as national seedings and hosting for regionals, it looks like TCU is going to get a regional. Oklahoma State, now that they have gotten the opportunity to play for a championship, they're a solid baseball team. They might get a chance for a regional. And Texas Tech is still looking to be in that national mix. Even though they didn't play that well in a Big 12 tournament up to their standards, they're still looking to get that national seed too. So a lot of decisions will be made. We'll find out tomorrow, noon Central time, when they announce the regionals coming up for the NCAA tournament. But you can pretty much bet your house mortgage that the University of Texas will host a regional coming up because of what they've done this year.
Yeah, all right, and man, I got to get out there, man. I want to see some of that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and it seems like there's a little bad blood, as I was mentioning, watching Arkansas, between Arkansas and Tennessee. They showed something between the managers earlier in the year, and they were face-to-face.
Yeah.
Each other, I mean, and so to see that as the SEC championship, that's going to be that they going that
Steve, ooh. It just means more out there, right? Ain't that what they say? It just means more.
Yes. Yes. Well, you know, I love controversial matchups because there's you know, there's nothing like having a little bad blood against an opponent. I'm sorry. I'm going to say it. I like it. If I'm playing a team, I don't particularly care for one or two of their players. That, to me, really makes it interesting. You want to go out there and put it to that team. And I've had opportunities throughout my sports career to do it. It's a lot of fun competing against those types of teams.
Yeah, no doubt. And that's what it's all about, especially with these baseball players, man. You see it all the time. There's ball thrown high and tight, coaches making questionable decisions, doing certain things. You know, these unwritten rules of the game that need to be handled and need to be written down for me. Please write them down so I'll know what these rules are. I don't need no unwritten rules anymore. I want to know what they are so people can understand. But you sit here and you look at the way baseball's going and what is expectations at the end of the year for college athletes. You guys are all been college athletes. You know what it's about. It's about dogpiling at Omaha. That's all it's about. All this happens for one reason and one reason alone. And that reason is I want a dogpile in Omaha as the national champion when it comes to baseball. And that's all that matters at this point now.
Hey, Chico, we got to, I'd like to move to follow battles in Arkansas. I think that would be a very unique perspective for our show to kind of chronicle that and this opportunity for that team.
And yeah, man, well, definitely. I can get his dad, you know, involved, and we'll get his dad on the show. Maybe get him on the show, depending on his availability. But I've been following him, watching.
What took you so long to say something?
Hey, man, hey, remember, I haven't really, you know, been on the show.
He's been in and out,
man. And when I come in and talk about the AAU segment, I mean, it's a lot to cover. So I knew the opportunity.
He's on the number one team in the nation. He's the starting shortstop.
Hey, man, I got a lot going on, brother. You know, hey, I wasn't ready, but it's exciting because, you know, knowing him literally, when I say I've known him since he was a baby, I really have. And growing up with his dad and his uncle and I are best friends. His uncle was in my wedding 30 years ago. I mean, we go way back. So
already.
Yeah, so we'll definitely we'll get them engaged and
all right, fair enough, Chico. Just giving you a little bit, like, man, how'd this guy fly under the radar? You
know, hey, Steve, you're giving it to me like we give it to you. I get it.
Do you?
Hey, because you give us a lot of opportunities to give it to you. So
Touche. Hey, listen, we're going to step aside and get on the hard court and see what we could do about 10 feet above the rim. Talk a little NBA when we get back. Stay with us right here on Laying Down the Law.
Moonshine Patio Bar and Grill serves great cooking with an innovative take on classic American comfort food. For over 10 years now, Chuck and Larry have delighted appetites and presented one of the best Sunday brunches ever at 303 Red River in Austin. Go by and enjoy some corn dog shrimp, cornflake chicken salad, boiled rainbow trout, and all my favorites and more. Moonshine Classic American Comfort Food. And of course, when you see Chuck and Larry, tell them Foss said hello. Moonshine Patio Bar and Grill.
Don't let pain keep you from doing the things you love. I'm Dr. Jason Garrett from Erosti. At Erosti, we fix pain fast. Whether you've been living with chronic and nagging pain for years, or if you've recently experienced an injury, our goal is to get you out of pain as quickly as possible. Erosti is completely natural and non-invasive. Plus, Erosti accepts most insurance plans. There's a location near you. Visit Erosti.com. That's Erosti.com. Erosti, we fix pain fast.
This is Chicago-style hot dog here. I'm not feeling too good. Turns out, along with all the other bad things my cholesterol does, they say it's a risk factor for strokes. Strokes? Sheesh. Good news from National Stroke Association. Exercising, eating right, and asking your doctor about medicines that can help lower your cholesterol, like statins, may reduce the risk of a first stroke. And if you've already had a stroke, it's even more important you lower your cholesterol.
Lower your chances of stroke by controlling your cholesterol. Visit stroke.org today.
When you read to your young children, you're helping them learn new words.
Which book do you want your daddy to read to you?
Moon! Good night, Moon!
And since it's during their first 3 years that they learn the most, it's very important that you start reading to them today.
In a big green room, there's a picture of a cow jumping over the moon.
For you, it's a pleasant moment. For them, it's a better future.
And the cow jumped over the
moon! Moon!
You and your loving care can be their best teachers. Message brought to you by El Valor and the Ad Council.
Howdy, Mr. Wildfire. What can I get you today?
Well, I'll have a toasted woodshed shingle sandwich, the backyard dry brush salad, and an old gazebo sundae sprinkled with precious photos and family heirlooms.
Anything to drink, sweet pea?
Yeah, carelessly stored paint thinner.
Knowing what Wildfire likes to eat is half the battle. Visit firewise.org to find out how you can help make your home more defensible against wildfires. Firewise.org, a public service brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council.
I want to thank my mommy for loving me so much.
For taking me to the doctor when I broke my foot.
For leaving me alone when I wanted to be alone.
And now, as a grown-up, I'm thankful for being able to take care of you, my dear mom. For taking you to your therapies. For understanding that sometimes you simply want to be alone.
Roles change without us noticing. That's why AARP gives you the information to provide even better care for your loved one. Visit aarp.org/caregiving. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Laying Down the Law is brought to you by Texas Spine Care Center, Cover 3 San Antonio, Coordinated Financial Group, and Hop Dottie Burger Bar.
We are back. We are Laying Down the Law. Rod Chico Tanner. Mike Hardball Harge. Anybody else you can remember, think about Chico, who is a national champion? You know, you got time to breathe today, son. Everybody knows Kellen Mond. Everybody knows, you know, Battles. These guys and gals, you know, their parents are your friends. They're your contemporaries. And they've gone on to be nationally looked at, and people are talking about all these folks, and they're right from your backyard.
Yeah, you know, I don't like to, you know, jump on it so much to where it's like I'm trying to take credit for what they did. It's exciting to know that I've had the opportunity to know them and be around them, but definitely, I don't go down the list of it in my mind. It as things surface, you know, I definitely will bring them to the forefront. But there are a lot of, I swear, if I really just sat down and put a list together of everybody that's probably come out of the South Texas district from AAU perspective that I know, and then there's people that may not have been part of AAU that are from San Antonio. I mean, the Central Texas and South Texas area has produced some great athletes on all the different fronts, and you know, and we go as far up, you know, north of Austin, all the way down to, you know, south into the Brownsville area, over to Corpus Christi, and I mean, there's a lot of athletes that have come out of this area that have done well on the collegiate and pro level.
Yeah, well, you said down to Brownsville, so you know, the Detmers are down that way, you know, Ty and Coy, and their dad was a longstanding high school football coach in Mission. Mission also home to the great Tom Landry, as I see the star behind you, Chico. And I'm not saying that I know Coach Landry played any AAU, but that was your mention about those who were not necessarily possibly in AAU, yeah, but in the district itself. And, yeah, you know, we go up and we touch the Killeen area where Mike is from, and there's a tremendous amounts of talent coming out of that area in a variety of sports with student athletes as well.
Yeah, a little Heisman Trophy winner from Copper's Cove, you know. RG3, who went on to play, you know, little football at Baylor and went on to play in the NFL, you know, a little Heisman Trophy. So, you know,
Heisman.
Yeah, you know, out of Copper's Cove, right around the corner from Killeen. So,
yes,
you know.
Sir. Yes, sir. Yeah. Well, like we were talking about a little while ago, I mean, just the fact of the kids and the athletes, and one of the things that you guys have touched on so much, and it's very poignant that we talk about it, is the multi-sports. You know, everybody in the day of age wants everyone to be a specialist, right? You can't. When I was younger, and I believe I might have told this story, I wanted to not play my senior year of high school football. And the reason why is because I knew my opportunities in baseball and I didn't want to risk it. And I would have regretted that so much because of the bonds and the friendships that I have to this day. I talked to at least 12 people off of that football team my whole entire high school career. I talk to them almost every single day, at least 12 of them. So the bonds that you have and the friendships that you keep throughout those times of the challenges of sports, let alone all my baseball friends and basketball with my kids and AAU and, you know, soccer and all this other stuff that we do. But the friendships and the movements of things that happen from there, the leaders that you become, the people that you network with that become part of your inner circle, those start from those times and those challenges and finding a way to make things happen.
Yeah, you know, yeah. I found that I still interact with some people that I played some sports with, and as we became adults, there's a different dynamic, and I'll twist it up just a little bit for you. I've noticed that our political views are different, but we still find a common ground because sports still gave us a common ground. Even as adults, we don't always have the same political views and the same views on the country and economics or whatever it may be. But the bond that we still have ties back to sports.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, you don't see different political preferences when we go to the Olympics. We were young, and the Miracle on Ice in 1980, everybody, I could have ran up and down my street in El Paso, Texas, and everybody would have been yelling USA when USA beat Russia in the semifinals. It wasn't, oh, well, wait a minute, what party affiliation are you? Oh, wait a minute, you're not Hispanic. Oh, wait a minute, you're not white. Wait a minute, you're not this. There was none of that. The whole place. And then when you went to school the next day, everybody was talking about the game. There was no divisiveness in any of that. It was, and so again, here's the disappointing part. And I don't want to bring this up as a negative. It's the fact that we can do it. We've shown that we can do it. So then why, for the most part, do we not do it when we've already shown on multiple occasions, and we'll do it again this summer with Tokyo? Will all be about USA. Oh, and the mile relay, and the
because it's,
relay,
it's,
and the this. And
it's
the
a convenience. It's a convenience thing, and it's my position that I still want to get across, and I want everybody to think the way I think. But I'm okay, and this is what I'm saying in the generality, not me personally, in a general statement. The people that are together doing those sports times, and in the Olympics is the best, dude. You're spot on with what you're saying. When the Olympics comes around, everybody's cheering for, you know, their country. As soon as it's over, it's like it never happened, because they got to go back to pushing their personal agenda and their personal, you know, situation, or the ego in jumps into the way. But you are spot on, man. As soon as the Olympics start, we're all going to be on the same team. You watch.
Nobody says, oh, what did the Black American get in this event? Or like, oh, well, that's okay.
Hey, sometimes they do say that, bro. Sometimes they do say that.
Now, for those who are not watching the video, the expression on my face was in agreement with Hardball. They do say that, and I mean – yeah, hey, but that's the thing, though, dude. We got to be real about it.
Yeah,
got to be real. Yeah. That's the first step to. And I'm going to say it like this: the first step to healing this country is being honest. And that a lot of times the problem is those who are trying to persecute another group of people or be mean or you know degrade someone. They don't want to be honest about the fact that they're doing it. That's the problem. You know, it's like in anybody who needs to be rehabilitated for anything, the first step is admitting that you have a problem. You know,
that's right.
Like, for example, Steve, you know, admitting that you have a problem, that you love to talk about El Paso, Texas all the time. Admit it first.
Hey, baby, the 915, son. Gotta get it done. From the city of the sun.
hey, Steve, go talk about El Paso. He gonna talk about Princeton. He gonna do it.
Whoa. Hey, hold
make
up,
sure
man.
Dean Cain is in that conversation.
Yeah, Dean Cain. We gotta remember Dean. Go talk about Dean Cain.
You popped the hardball. You throw it at me, man. You throw it at me early in the count.
I'm hitting you with flurries. I'm hitting you with flurries.
But again, the first step is admitting that there is a situation. And when we talk, let's go back to the Olympics. Let's go back to this country. You know, in admitting that we have issues, and that's the biggest problem that we have. And sports, again, let's keep it. This is a sports show, but sports is a great mechanism to bring us together.
Yeah. Yeah. Or unless, unless you're a fan in the stands in Washington or Philly dumping popcorn out, then it changes the entire landscape.
Let's get into some NBA and close it out. But yeah, and here's the thing. You have to have consequences. You just can't drop popcorn on a grown man and think that everything's going to be okay, because we don't go to your job and do the same thing to you. I'll leave you with that. Laying Down the Law will be right back. We will finish strong and we will finish well. He is Mike Harge. He is the co-host, Rod Chico Tanner. I'm Steve Foster. We'll be back right after this.
Panera favorites are hot and ready to serve for dinner. Taste our creamy mac and cheese served in a crispy bread bowl. Or the classic bacon turkey Bravo featuring our signature sauce. How about our new mouth-watering Chipotle chicken and bacon flatbread pizza? These and other favorites are waiting for you. Order dinner tonight for delivery or pickup. Only at Panera. Availability and pricing may vary.
Research shows people remember radio ads that remind them of the past. So to help you remember that Liberty Mutual Insurance Company customizes your home insurance so you only pay for what you need, here's an ad that'll really take you back.
Back in my day, I heard a voice from the radio say, Liberty Mutual customizes my home insurance so I only pay for what I need. I'm getting on in years now, but heavens to Betsy, there are some things an old fella like me just never forgets.
Only pay for what you need at libertymutual.com.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
All right, is that a Q2 or Q3 expense?
Dwayne CPA went MIA. W9. To keep his books and his sanity, he needs to find a replacement ASAP.
Hey, Johnny, have you ever heard of a fungible good?
Indeed can help him hire the people he needs.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. When you sponsor a job, you immediately get your short list of quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job criteria. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
Listen to this station anytime, anywhere on Odyssey. Odyssey is your new audio home for all the music, news, sports, and podcasts that matter to you. Odyssey. That's AUDACY.
Texas Spine Care Center and Dr. Adam Brueggemann are committed to treating chronic back pain and helping patients understand and make informed decisions about orthopedic treatment. They focus on using the latest techniques, medicines, and practices to give their patients the best treatment options to manage and overcome pain. Texas Spine Care Center is committed to helping San Antonio find the best choices that will give you your life back. So call 210-941-1785 or go to TexasSpineCareCenter.com. 210-941-1785.
If you're a bacon lover, I've got great news for you. This is Michael Kielbasa with Kielbasa Smoked Meats. Our authentic dry-cured bacon is now available at grocery stores near you. We make it the old-fashioned way with the finest pork bellies and our legendary spice blend. We don't pump it full of water or chemicals like other brands. All you get is thick, savory slices of delicious bacon. I hope you'll give it a try. And if it's not the best bacon you've ever eaten, I'll give you your money back. Kielbasa Smoked Meats, slow-crafted in Texas since 1949.
Daddy, why is the sky blue?
To match your pretty eyes.
Nope. See, all colors have wavelengths that are diffused by oxygen and nitrogen. Since blue has the shortest wavelength, it's diffused up to 10 times more.
Who taught you that?
Mommy.
By sixth grade, too many girls lose interest in math and science, which they'll need for most future jobs. Keep her interest alive. For ideas, go to girlsgotech.org. It's her future. Do the math. A public service message brought to you by Girl Scouts of the USA and the Ad Council.
Sundays are for the grill. The Sunday Sports Grill, 11 in the morning to 1. Chop it up and grill with former and current Rock the Mic champs Michael Jimenez and Quinn Hudson. The Sunday Sports Grill, 11 to 1 every Sunday.
Laying Down the Law is brought to you by Texas Spine Care Center, Cover 3 San Antonio, Coordinated Financial Group, and Hop Dottie Burger Bar.
We're back. We're laying down the law. Rod Chico Tanner, Mike Hardball Hard. I'm your host, Steve Foster. And yes, I will never back away from El Paso, Texas. That is home. That is the one spot in the world that if I have to seek refuge, if as long as I can get to the 915, life is good for me.
That's cool.
Any point in time.
Hey man, you can go hang out with Sherman Hensley.
you know, he did. That's right. George Jefferson, and is resided in El Paso until he passed away. Yeah. And so, yes, we do have a few folks that have come from there. Sandra Day O'Connor, the first female Supreme Court justice. Don Haskins, as he led Texas Western to the first all-black starting five NCAA championship, and the great Neville Shedd, residing now in San Antonio, Texas.
Yeah, so he's on my AAU committee, so appreciate Neville.
So we give you a little bit. We give you a little bit of San Antonio, Chico.
Yeah, you know? So hey, man, I want to go back to that Sixth Man Award from Jordan Clarkson, man. You know, one of the few, you know, players that come off the bench as a sixth man and scoring 30 points. You know, that's big stuff right there.
Yeah.
Well, let's do this. Let's go to the phone line and talk to somebody who understands the Utah Jazz and some of the NBA, the one and only Stephen Howard. Stephen, good morning and welcome back to Laying Down the Law.
Hey, man, what's up? How you guys doing?
Doing well. Hey, we want to send our condolences to you and the teammates of Mark Eaton. I don't know what it is with 7-foot guys riding bicycles and getting in trouble, but that was horrible news to hear for a guy that did so well, Defensive Player of the Year a couple times, and I think your teammate at Utah.
Yeah, that was tragic news yesterday. Really shocking. I just, you know, talked to him last week. You know, speaking of playoffs, because I forget the Celtics player had 9 blocks in a game, and Mark Eaton still has the record for 10 blocks in a playoff game. But yeah, yes. tragic news. So, yeah, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. And I watched the game last night, Utah Jazz. Mitchell, I love Donovan Mitchell. The man can light it up from anywhere. And how do you feel about Utah's opportunity in this year's NBA playoffs?
You know, I think they have a great opportunity. Donovan Mitchell still is going to have a little bit of, I don't know, assimilation or acclimation to get back into the swing of things, even though he did have a great game last night. But yeah, they have all the pieces that you need to make that, you know, great playoff run. And they played so well throughout the season. But, you know, as you've seen, there's a lot to do with luck, you know, to winning. And the fact that Donovan got injured, you know, was unlucky for them. And so another injury could, you know, mess up that team again. But you got Gobert, you know, defensively, Bogdanovich, you know, he filled in greatly when Donovan was out. Ingles off the bench. So, yeah, they have all the great components to make that championship run. But they're going to need some luck to, you know, continue going on.
Let's bring it back. This is Mike Harge, and we're talking to Stephen Howard. Stephen, let's be honest. The reason why Utah is going to win is because of K-Town, Killeen, Texas's own Royce O'Neal. Royce O'Neal was lighting that net up last night, and that is something that Royce has the capability of doing. But seriously, the team and their chemistry, every time I watch them, it seems to get better and better because of some of the things that you said defensively, Rudy Gobert and other guys coming in. Does Quinn Snyder have everybody understanding their role on this team?
Yeah, and that's a great point because – you know, when you have people to understand and embrace their role and flourish under that, you know, that's when you have a team that's going to, you know, go far and do well. And I love Royce O'Neal. I covered him when he was playing at Baylor. And it was funny because when he was, you know, trying out for the Jazz, well, even before that, when in the summer league, I saw his mom and I talked to his mom to kind of give him some advice and say, look, you know, he's got the great components to be successful in the NBA and to just, you know, stick it out. And, you know, I always thought that he had the potential to be a good NBA player, and he's far exceeded, you know, what I thought he was going to be able to do in the NBA.
Yeah, Mama Deborah don't play, man. She don't play.
What about the sixth man? You know, this show is giving you everybody or at least two or three starters. Jordan Clarkson, as Rod Chico Tanner had mentioned earlier, the Sixth Man of the Year award. He's from the San Antonio area, and Chico knows that family and him very well.
Yeah, you know, Jordan Clarkson is you know, played a pivotal role for them throughout the year, being that guy to come off the bench that can just light it up and who knows his role and embraces it, you know, and it can be difficult, you know, to be, you know, hey, I'm a starter in my mind and then, you know, start playing off the bench. But he's, you know, he's embraced that role well and, you know, had a breakout year.
Talking with Stephen Howard, former NBA player, Utah, San Antonio Spurs in his mix as well. All right, let's just get to something that people probably want to know about. What would Stephen Howard do if somebody dumped popcorn on your head?
Man, that was crazy. It was unfortunate. But I'm almost a little bit glad that it happened in the way that it happened and the way that the players have spoken out, because, you know, and it kind of goes back to the Kwame Brown situation and the mental health situation of the NBA, or really all professional sports. Just, you know, guys are out there playing, you know, basketball or any sport, and you know, for some reason, fans just feel like that ticket gets them the right to just go into an arena or a stadium and just act a fool when, you know, being a good person, you know, should be what's on people's mind and winning the right way. But to, you know, dump popcorn or to, you know, talk about someone's, you know, wife or child and, you know, in an ugly fashion, like, that's just classless. And, you know, people need to start getting banned, you know, for life to stop sort of that, because, you know, people do that to get clout, you know, and you know, become a social media sensation or whatever. And it's like, no, like, you know, someone could get hurt, you know, someone could put something stronger into something and throw, you know, a coin. I got hit with a coin when I played in Greece, and I wanted to go up there and just dismantle whoever, like, and I didn't know who threw it, and I had a knot on my head for like 2 months. So yeah, there's no place for that in sports, because as we've seen, you know, if the players do go up there, they're going to get suspended for 10, you know, maybe 20 games, lose hundreds of thousands of dollars. And, you know, why shouldn't they be protected better than they are, you know, currently?
Agreed.
So I got a quick question. What do you think, there's any sleeper or any shocker that could possibly happen in this playoff series?
Oh, man. The only shocker to me would be if the Clippers were to survive, because I think they are DOA, and, you know, they pulled out that last game. But, you know, like, you know, you essentially, I feel like you have players on that team that are, you know, fighting for their careers, just because they're going to have to blow that up if they don't win the series, which I don't think they will.
Steven, always a pleasure, man. And it's great to see you doing a lot of things in the business world as well. We'd love to have you back as the playoffs progress. Talk a little bit more about what you're doing. It's great to see athletes be great business persons as well. And that's impressive to me, to Chico and the Hardball, because we look to do the same. So we appreciate your example off the court. And we love having you on. And again, condolences to your former teammate and good friend, Mark Eaton.
Yeah, I appreciate that. And yeah, would love to come back on. But yeah, thank you for the sympathies. I appreciate that.
Appreciate you. All right. That's going to do it for us on this Sunday. Man, it was great having Chico ride. Get that grill fired up. At least take a photo, Chico, and show us what you're working with. And Hardball, we'll get the updates next week. What's going on with college baseball?
Cover 3 at Stone Oak in San Antonio is the place to be. Whether you're looking to gather coworkers for lunch, dine with friends, or treat your sweetie to a fabulous dinner, this elegant restaurant offers ample seating with comfortable leather booths, tall